I think the bone bomb was for getting rid of the guards outside their cage. These guys, the cobblepots. Now, how do I get these guys out?
I'm not really. I hope you didn't waste it on that.
Really? Okay. That works. I assume they would have, if the cobblepots were alive, they would have made a couple of bombs or something, and I would have used some to take out the guards and then have this one left. Maybe in here we'll find a key to open those doors.
The goblins love stories, especially fairy tales, and they always wanted to hear more.
I like the kids.
I love stories too, Grandpa.
As do I. But the goblins were obsessed with them. They couldn't just enjoy their stories like you or me. They based their whole lives around them, collecting and hoarding everything they could.
Like that sword.
Treasured tales, even if it meant stealing.
That purple sword reminds me of the sword on my channel banner. That one looks like a human. What the hell are they doing? The hell? That's like a human dressed in goblin stuff. Who the hell could that be? This is where it came from, right? Yeah. I think. Yep. Can't go that way. Which is good, because they'd probably catch me. Because I do stupid crap like that. Ooh, a shot.
I need to be careful I don't get caught with this.
Huh. If so, we'll just get it back from our little hidey hole. Spacebar for that, and that's it. We could use those. It looked like, what is it? Bolt cutters to open the locks. What's up here? Anything? Can't reach? Well, maybe with more people, maybe this will be the way out, right? We can't go in here, can we? No. So what were they doing? Why did he lift that pipe off? Did they want to retrieve the bolt cutters themselves? If so, why did they do it? Why didn't they go in and get it? Strange. Okay. Now let's see if we can break them free. So I'm thinking that the bolt cutters might break when we get her out. But if so, she'll be able to help us open that door. that we need two people with to open. We might find something else past there.
But what about the other prisoners?
The faster we get out of here, the faster we can save everyone. Now move that sweet tuchus!
Can we save the others?
I was off to seek an audience with the Goblin King. If I could get my hands on his key, perhaps I could set the other prisoners free.
Ooh, look at that
thing. Did you have a particular reason for choosing Amaya?
That thing's cool again.
Are you kidding me? Why wouldn't I want the bravest person in Daventry by my side?
Plus she's cute.
But the Hobblepots could have whipped up a potion to take all those rock bottoms out.
They're dead. Can't very well save them if they're dead.
Would you mind calling for a guard to carry her off to bed?
But, Grandfather, I'd like to hear more.
Which part did you like the best? The mischievous goblins? Or the interrupting boy who wanted to tell a different story?
I was enjoying the goblins. Absolutely, I was. I just wanted to show you that I could...
I think it's best to call it a night. The storm has calmed down, and so has she.
But, Grandfather, I...
Gart!
I just wanted to...
This is not a time for debating.
Oh, my.
Go to bed. We can continue in the morning.
As you wish. Good night.
But I don't want to hear the end of the story. How did we...
Gart, wait. Sorry, I didn't mean to snap. These elixirs have my nerves on edge.
Did I save the bakers?
It's okay, Grandfather. And thank you. I do still have a lot to learn from your stories.
Sweet dreams, Gart. Sleep well.
That I can do with my eyes closed.
Now you're learning.
That's funny. That was cute.
There. That's our ticket out.
Okay, good. Back to it. I thought it was ending now.
I'm not doing that.
I'll go ahead.
I've seen these column things before.
I wasn't sure if I could get her across, but she made me believe I could.
Is this trial and error? I think the middle one was bad in the game. The first. I can't go anywhere else. Okay.
Go.
Aw. Oh, crap. Left.
Left.
No! Can I go over? I can do it over. Okay. So I went right, obviously. Right, right, forward. And then just straight forward, all these ones.
Go.
I won't steer you wrong this time. Go right.
Right. Right. Forward.
You can only go forward and left.
Left. Left. Forward.
Now, I'm really just guessing. Left? Or is it merely any way that I do it is right? I just have to make her do the same way. Achaka. Alright, we went left.
Left.
Left?
Left.
Forward?
Forward.
It's actually good in small sections like this. Right?
Right.
Imagine if they had us do this whole thing in one shot. I'd be writing everything down. Okay. Oh, time to go right again? Oh, I didn't even want to go to that one. I hope I steer the right way. Go right?
Right.
Left?
Left.
Right?
Right.
Left?
Left.
I think I hit there first, right?
Right.
Okay. Left?
Left.
Forward, forward.
Thanks, King Graham.
She's cute. I don't want to skip. Ooh. How close are we to the end of this?
Quick! In my cape! No time to explain!
That's a pretty magic cape. Oh, I can't access inventory. I want to see her in my inventory. Let me guess, it's a shadow of something. It's not even... the dragon's not even there. Ooh, what's that? He's a cute dragon. You can be my little buddy.
Nightmares come in many forms. Once you realize what you are actually afraid of, you can start to deal with the fear.
Now I have that in my cape as well. She had a cute name for a bunny, I forget what it was.
It's not gonna work. I'm not afraid of you.
Oh my. Naked mole rats.
I figured after that scream you'd be back. Let's pick up our story once again.
Were they real?
I wasn't actually afraid of dragons. I was still struggling with the loss of a chaka.
Yeah.
Now... my decisions meant the life or death of a kingdom. That's the true beast I needed to wrestle with.
Yeah, there's a human in there. Wait. There she is. Amaya? Dragon baby. Cute. And some pages and chopsticks. Anything to do around here? This is a dead end. What's that? Oh, I can make scary shadows. I'm gonna put the dragon there, obviously. The baby dragon. Oh, I can't get over to them. I thought, like, I could get over to them or interact with some way. So, who's in there? One of the guards? I can't think of anyone left from the original game. There's definitely a human being in there.
Really? I hope you didn't waste it on that.
You just called Amaya it? Bye! Whoever it is, it's someone very skinny. Not human? Hmm. Oh, the dragon baby's gone. Alright. I still have her in my inventory. She's not very thrilled with that, is she? Wait. Don't get stuck. No. Okay.
I didn't need to wear his crown to be a great king. My old hat suited me just fine. And Daventry was ready for a new adventure.
Well, the adventure's almost over, isn't it? Look at all those books. What was that? Number one? A prize for something. For the most amount of books? So I guess the only thing I can really interact with is this in the middle. By Manny? Manny.
Once in a town just like the one you're imagining, there was a beautiful castle that stood high on a hill.
Wallace Shawn. Forget his character's name in this, but he was, yeah, one of the three guards we were competing against to become Knight of the Realm or whatever.
All were welcome here. Well, everyone except for the pests.
I love that guy.
The townspeople cried out to their king, "We must be rid of these rats! They're scaring our children and stealing our cheese!"
Yeah, no, we need cheese.
Even ate a baby.
What?
The town had become very unpleasant indeed.
Hmm. And she looks like the baker's wife.
Every morning, gold coins clanged through the water well carrying wishes for a better town. But the rats remained.
Hmm.
The king, in his finite wisdom,
had
also been casting wishes, for he desperately needed a plan. As wishes would have it, a wandering piper appeared at the castle gates.
Hmm. And is that who we're dealing with now, this piper? It's been turned into a goblin king or goblin, I don't know, someone to beat on.
The piper offered to expel the rats from the kingdom if the town would overthrow their moronic liege.
Hmm.
"Hear, hear," they cried out. "Our throne is but a seat for a hat rack. Rid us of these pests, and the throne is where you'll rest."
Hmm.
The stranger pulled out a small flute and played a pleasing melody. The music summoned the rats out of hiding, and they danced on the head of the king!
He's apparently enjoying that fully.
The king shrieked a high-pitched squeal! But the piper continued his song. The rats were led back to the wooded forest where they belonged.
Well,
the piper returned to the castle to claim his reward, but his knock echoed throughout the halls, and no one let him in.
Nice. He must have been kind of pissed.
He raised his pipe, and a new melody was played. He watched the drawbridge lower, and a mesmerized kingdom pranced to his side.
Well, they could have just done that in the first place, right?
With a few simple notes and a turn on the heel, the stranger led them from the castle to the deep, dark caverns below.
And they became the goblins?
The throne is now empty, and the well doesn't clang anymore.
So that's like the well.
Manny knew exactly what to write to incite the horde. He chose every word carefully, fully knowing how the goblins would react.
Oh, that's Manny.
Story.
His name's Manny.
It was brilliant. They did all the dirty work.
And this is just
he
a story.
I sat back and watched. I thought I had bested him in the duel of wit, but the mind games were just beginning.
Hmm. Huh. Now what? Goblin pranks to fool your friends. 1001 goblin pranks. The baby swap. Huh. You're like, they really wouldn't notice the difference. Any more books to look at over on this side? No. Wouldn't they notice the book out of place? I can't take it, apparently. Doesn't this girl want to get out of my cloak now?
Do nightmares ever come true?
Of course, but real monsters are far easier to deal with than imaginary ones.
Wait. Now, we read the story in the game. We didn't hear Manny's voice read that. So how do we know that was Manny? I mean, obviously we heard his voice, but...
Ugh. Goblins ruin everything.
Huh.
Yes, I'm so bad. Really? I hope you didn't waste it on that.
Okay. Guess I can't get in there, at least not yet.
This is hard as corn.
Oh, what the hell? Three little pigs.
Distress!
Help us, King! Enough! They're only stories. Can't you just enjoy them for what they are? You've missed the point entirely. Is this how you want your story to be remembered?
Oh.
Wait. How about a new story?
Yeah.
Once upon a time, there lived, let me see what I got here.
Am I supposed to pick these pages?
There lived a strong little goblin.
I'll pick turn instead.
Loved adventures.
Nice.
Even in his young age, stories of the goblin's quests had spread around the land.
So they're acting out three little
things.
Like
the time he...
Jump-kicked an evil serpent lord.
Jump-kicked an evil serpent lord!
Uh-oh.
No, that can't be right. Wait a minute here.
He bear-hugged a basilisk.
Bear hugged a basilisk. No, that can't be right.
Okay.
Wait a minute here.
This gotta just be outsmarted a quizzical griffin. Oh, for some reason I thought it said goblin here. Alright, that's good then.
Outsmarted quizzical griffin. In fact, his adventures were so legendary, the goblins decided to make him king. But the goblin adventurer was out of his element and overwhelmed with the work it took to run a successful kingdom. His friends offered their...
Wisdom.
Wisdom.
What's he doing?
He's for a wooden key.
I don't like that.
Let me try that again.
Strength.
Strength. Let me try that again.
Am I just choosing the wrong one, or is the game, like, setting me up that whatever last one I pick is the right one? Heart?
Heart.
I don't see any clues for this.
But it wasn't
Which one's
enough.
The right one?
He was afraid he would never live up to the king who came before. It got so bad that the goblin gave up. But when packing up his things to run away from the castle, the goblin found... He found...
A page of bravery.
No, that can't be right. Wait a minute here. Let me try that again.
The hat.
His old adventurer cap.
Da da da, dun 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 dun.
And the goblin realized that he wasn't just here to continue the previous legacy. He was here to create his own. One filled with...
bravery?
Bravery. And the best group of friends you could ever ask for.
Now let us free you, freakazoid. Nice.
Grandpa's gotta hear about this.
Kicking some rat butt over there.
Told you he'd save us.
No, I told you he'd save us.
Well, I think it was me, actually. You know, I'm not even sure anymore.
So who's the human goblin thing? Is it Whisper?
All right, Mr. Fancy Cakes, a River Barachi.
And that's my story. Some of the details might have changed over the years, and I certainly left out some parts I wasn't fond of. But I found it's best to enjoy stories for what they are.
True.
And not for what you hoped they would be.
So true, the outcome of this game. Because I hoped I would save everybody, but the Hobblepots died.
You've fallen asleep again, and I think it's time I do the same.
And Mr. Fancy Pants died, unfortunately. But appreciate the stories for what they are, not what you hoped they would be. And plus, I don't want to play the thing all over again. Is that the Piper after all? Who the hell are you? And where is he?
You look like you could use a friend.
Manny. I'll have to remember that name now. Ha. Finished. Not a perfect job, guys, but hope you understand it's a blind LP. Thanks so much for watching. Whenever I finish the third chapter, I'll start putting up videos for it, so I'm pretty much putting this up as a bonus LP, as some of you might know if you're watching this currently. Whenever I have time, when I'm, like, basically have a good backlog with the two other games I'm playing, I'll play another chapter and upload it. So thanks so much for watching. Gonna let the credits roll out. And here's hoping for a better episode for episode 3. Take care, guys. Endure. In enduring, grow strong.